Osteoarthritis, or degenerative joint disease, occurs when the protective cartilage on the ends of bones wears down. This can occur in any joint, but is more common in certain joints like the elbows, knees, and hips. When bone becomes less protected, inflammation results with swelling, stiffness, and discomfort or pain. The prefix of osteo is used to distinguish this disease from other arthritic conditions that are due to an infection or an autoimmune disease like rheumatoid arthritis. Typically, osteoarthritis is a concern in older pets, but earlier onset can happen with improper feeding early in life, especially with large and giant breed dogs. Dogs with an ideal body condition are typically considered large or giant breeds when they weigh more than 60 pounds or 27 kilograms as adults. Osteoarthritis is commonly diagnosed with X-ray imaging or radiographs, but a strong suspicion may be raised based on clinical signs and physical examination. Pets with arthritis may be less active or have a lameness with joint discomfort that can be elicited by the veterinarian feeling and bending the joint. It is not uncommon for osteoarthritis to be underdiagnosed in older cats, even though it can be common. Losing extra body weight can reduce the amount of force being placed on inflamed joints. Thus, if a pet is overweight, losing weight can provide a great deal of relief. For a more comprehensive discussion on how to nutritionally manage weight, please see the weight management video in this series. Key strategies discussed in that video include feeding less calories than are needed, nutrient enhancement, energy density reduction, caloric distribution modifications, increased feeding frequency and treating, and providing supplemental compounds, especially L-carnitine. Lowering of the omega-6 to long-chain omega-3 fatty acid ratio can be helpful in the nutritional management of osteoarthritis. During any inflammatory process, the body's immune cells make eicosanoids, which are signaling molecules. Eicosanoids can be made from omega-6 or long-chain omega-3 fatty acids. Eicosanoids made from omega-6 fatty acids are better at signaling. This means that eicosanoids made from omega-3 fatty acids are not as effective at signaling, and as a consequence, consumption of foods rich in long-chain omega-3 fatty acids can actually reduce inflammation. This reduction in inflammation can potentially decrease the discomfort that is felt with osteoarthritis. Although shorter-chain omega-3 fatty acids like alpha-linolenic acid that comes from terrestrial plants can be elongated to the long-chain omega-3 fatty acids EPA and DHA, their conversion is poor. Thus, the common use of marine oils and/or fish to enrich foods with these less inflammatory fatty acids. At times, a concern is raised about the antigenicity of these oils, but some products are distilled, reducing the likelihood of this, as can the use of oils or fatty acids from fish species or algae that are not as commonly used in pet food. Ratios can be variable depending on what specific fatty acids are included in the calculation, but one often looks for linoleic acid plus arachidonic acid to EPA plus DHA ratios of less than 3. Glucosamine and chondroitin sulfate are natural substances found in and around the cells of cartilage. Glucosamine is an amino sugar that the body produces, which is distributed in cartilage as well as other connective tissues. Glucosamine is suggested to strengthen cartilage and assist with glycosaminoglycan synthesis. Glycosaminoglycans, also known as GAG, are a major part of joint cartilage. There is a great deal of debate regarding the effectiveness of glucosamine in the management of osteoarthritis, and there are limits on its inclusion in pet food, especially when from a synthesized or purified form and not from a natural source like poultry or fish cartilage. Chondroitin sulfate is a natural gag that helps cartilage retain water, which helps it to resist compression and act like a shock absorber. Chondroitin sulfate also appears to have anti-inflammatory effects. These effects are of significant debate, and like glucosamine, there can be regulatory limits to the chondroitin sulfate inclusion in pet food, especially when added in a synthesized or purified form. Fortunately, glucosamine and chondroitin sulfate are considered very safe, so they often are tried to see if they will have any beneficial effects. Nutritional management of osteoarthritis is often used in conjunction with anti-inflammatory drugs. Since these drugs do have side effects, especially on the GI tract but also on the kidney and liver, efforts to reduce the needed dose and/or frequency of medication with concurrent dietary therapy are often made. As osteoarthritis is a progressive disease, the main goal with any treatment is to increase comfort and thus mobility and quality of life.